remember I mentioned about creating two forms of life, matter and life, and then within life, two formats, animal format and human format. When God created an animal, and remember again, each one of us is very unique. God could have made a factory, could have called his angels, come on up guys, let's write some specifications. I want 3.5 billion men, 3.5 billion women, and I want all men to be 6 feet precisely, not a millimeter less, and their nose bridges to be 2.5 inches, their forehead 3 inches wide, and nobody is going to vary from this specification. I want precise production of men and women. God could have chosen to do that. But what did God do instead? He created us to be very unique beings. That is, our own thumbprint, eyeprint, our DNA is different. We are so unique. God wants us to be unique. And respecting and accepting that uniqueness is all about worship. So when he created animals, he knew that each animal is unique. And there is going to be fight between animals for three things: for air space, for food, and for the loved ones. There is always going to be limited resources and fight for it. So what did God do? He told the goats, look, and goats and deer, I'm going to give you horns. You fight it out. You nail it down. Whoever wins, wins. Then he told the tigers, lions, cats, I'm going to give you paws. You tear them apart. And then fangs. And then the other, they gave the paws to, like the bear and all, they got the paws to tear apart. Animals resolve their differences through these three things. When Adam was created, probably he asked, God, it would be nice for me to have the horns, fangs, and paws I can fight with everyone out there. God said, Adam, you are not getting anything. So what am I getting? How do I fight with others to protect myself? He said, I'm going to give you something better. You don't have to die for existence. You can live on. I have given you the life. I'll give you some tools. I said, God, what is the tool? He says, I'm going to give you the ability to talk. If you and another individual has a conflict, you talk it out. You guys are humans. You can talk it out and resolve your conflicts, and you don't have to resort to horns, fangs, and paws. And that's how we as humans need to resolve our conflicts, through dialogue. There is nothing you cannot do without dialogue. For that, we need to be intelligent enough to see the problems. I know this is the common question asked, how would you deal with Hitler? We allowed him to get to that point. He should have been stopped. People should have seen the signs when he was started separating Jews. We should have stopped at him at that time. Nobody did it. It was too late to talk to him at that time. What we as Americans did was the right thing, bomb the hell out of him. But as humans, dialogue is the right thing to do with the least damage. Thank you.